shouts pigs when the guards pass. He calls his rolling skills art even when rolled in public parks. He lost his father, lies to his mother. Dead to his sister, steals from his brothers. Still he holds his abusive robbing scum at the nearest TD or some other poor, politically pertained prick. He isn't like you and me, no, he's the epitome of all things wrong with this system. And by God is he brazen, unlike any youth I've ever met. Still he claims it's disrespect when he's thrown off the Lewis for public indecency. But I'm not talking about his dick, I'm talking about his feet. I'm talking about his toe, the high, the heroin, looking for somewhere to go, looking for somewhere to flow, looking for somewhere to... Oh. He finds a vein, the substance, a savior, direct to his brain, and the hurt and the pain, if only for a little while. It's just about now that he's noticed by a child who until then was full of smiles, pure dreams. Now he's screaming, "Mammy, that man's dead." "No, son, he's just off his head." "So we have to ask you to leave." "Mammy, help him, he can't breathe." "So we have to ask you to leave." "Why are they doing that? What did he do?" "Sit your arse down, that's enough out of you." A quick heave and a hasty lob, it's all part of the job. It's 4 or 5 times a monthly. It's a free country. Comes a hey shout from the Lewis stop. An angry look from one of the state's goons and a sad laugh from the other. The boy gets dragged back to his seat by his mother, away from the crumpled stranger. And as that carriage moves along, distancing them from their perceived danger, that little boy prays for that monster